Hallelujah, praise God. I'm so excited for the month of March. When we enter the month of March, it says many things are happening. The spring is coming, hopefully. That's one thing. Things get warmed up, and we are still tropical people now. No matter how many years we have spent in this country, we cannot remain tropical people. We will like warmth and heat. But let me tell you, no matter how cold it is outside, it is always hot in the presence of God. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Last Sunday, we talked about the vision of the church, isn't it? And we said, we ended the series in Christ alone. We said we are built as a church in the presence of Most High God. Hallelujah. Praise God. And I'm going to just bridge that last sermon to what we're going to talk in the month of March. We have not done this before, but that was God laid on my heart that we're going to spend the whole year, whole month in a series based on the church. One amen is good. I'm okay with one amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. So we may call this sermon series Ecclesia. Everybody say Ecclesia.
Ecclesia.
Is it? If you don't know how to spell it, that's fine. If you don't know how to spell Ecclesia, you have to write the spelling of Ecclesiastes. That's all right, too. Ecclesia, it is in your Bible, okay? I'm not speaking any other language. Praise God. Ecclesia means a separated out people for God. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. That is why the book written by Solomon says Ecclesiastes Sabha Sikshak Nu Pustak. Isn't it? Let me translate in Gujarati. Ecclesia means Sabha. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We are not just any Sabha. And especially we are not the Mahasabha. We are God's chosen people, anointed for His purpose in His kingdom to make a change, make a difference in this world where we are. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. The word ecclesia is a Greek word that comes more than 115 times in New Testament. The reason that we say we do word count is not that we can share the knowledge. That's not the purpose. But if the occurrence is so frequent, I would understand that emphasis is given to that word. Isn't it? When I say the word love comes so many times by Apostle John, then we can understand that is why he's called the Apostle of Love. When the Bible says 115 times Ecclesia in New Testament, we understand that it is important for God what Ecclesia is, what church is. So we're not going to spend one Sunday, we're going to spend the month of March looking at Ecclesia. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. And before I go into the Word of God, the spine, the words that we're going to look at, which is the spine of the whole series, which comes from the book of Acts of Apostles. Pretana Krutyo, Bijo, Dhyana, Betalis, Mikalam. That is the spine of the series of the Ecclesia. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. And we have read it. We have memorized it. If you have attended any of the baptism classes, this verse has definitely been told you hundreds of times. And we are just waiting for some people to join in. We're going to have baptism class again. I'm just saying by faith, nobody has told me, but I will know that there will be people getting baptized this year as well. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My Bible says, and they continued steadfastly. Another translation says, they devoted themselves. Everyone said devoted.
Devoted.
We understand what devotion is. Isn't it? Gujarati ma kahe ki devo dhradta thi lagu raha. Isn't it? એનો મતલબ એમ નહીં કે એમને ટાઈમ મળ્યો ત્યારે એમણે કર્યું. એનો મતલબ એમ પણ નહીં કે વેન એવર ધે ગેટ અ ઓપોર્ચ્યુનિટી ધે ડીડ ઇટ ઇન અ મિનિમમ વે. બટ માય બાઇબલ સેઝ ધે ડિવોટેડ ધેમસેલ્વ્સ. ધેટ વોઝ ધેર ફોકસ. ઇફ આઈ મે સે ધેટ ઇટ બીકેમ અ ગોલ ઓફ ધેર લાઈફ. ધેટ બીકમ ધેર વિઝન. ધેટ બીકમ ધેટ વિઝન. ઇફ યુ અપ્લાય ટુ યુનિવર્સિટી, લોટ ઓફ ટાઈમ ધે આસ્ક યુ ફોર સ્ટેટમેન્ટ ઓફ પર્પસ. આઈ એમ નોટ શ્યોર ઇફ યુ રિટન ઇટ. આઈ હેવ રિટન ઇટ. ઇટ ઇઝ અ હાર્ડ થિંગ ટુ ડુ. Because when people don't have purpose, what to write in a statement of purpose? Isn't it? Hallelujah. So let me say it this way. When we are God's people, this is the statement of purpose. Hallelujah. Praise God. And it says, they devoted themselves to four things. Hallelujah. They devoted themselves to apostles' doctrine, fellowship, breaking of bread, and
prayer.
Let's say prayer. Come on. Prayer. We can say in the church, we can speak in the church. Kali Sauthi Santi Kabrastan Mahajan, this is not a Kabrastan. This is a live church of God. So we make noise here, isn't it? We shout out, we speak up, because dead men don't speak and we are not dead anymore. I was once dead, but not anymore. I was blind once, but not anymore, isn't it? So I'm going to speak up, I'm going to shout out. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. So four things they did. ગુજરાતીમાં લખ્યું છે, પ્રેરિતોના બોધમાં, સંગતમાં, રોટલી ભાંગવામાં તથા પ્રાર્થનામાં દ્રઢતાથી લાગુ રહ્યા. થેન્ક યુ. ટેલ યોર નેબર ડિવોટેડ ધેમસેલ્વ્સ. Is that it? Praise God. Thank you. So out of this Ecclesia series, the first sermon series, first sermon that I'm going to talk about, a devoted church. Because that's what the purpose of church is. And out of devoted church, I know I'm not going in the right order, but I have a method to my madness. I'm going to pick communion first today. I'm going to talk about devoted themselves to the breaking of bread. Why? Because today is a communion day. Isn't it? Thank you. I said I have method to my madness. Isn't it? Praise God. Trust me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And this is amazing. Hallelujah. And when the subject of communion comes, we ask, is it the wine or the grape juice? Is it the wafer? Is it the bread? Is it the rotli? Rotli hoy to lage communion lido. Listen, is it બેઠા બેઠા લેવાનું કે ઉભા થઈને લેવાનું, પાછળ રહેવાનું કે આગળ આવવાનું, મહિનામાં એક વાર લેવાનું, છ મહિને લેવાનું, વર્ષ વર્ષ લેવાનું? એન્ડ લેટ મી ટેલ યુ, નોન ઓફ ધોઝ ક્વેશ્ચન્સ આર ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ. એન્ડ વેન વી ટર્ન ટુ ફોકસ ઓન ઓલ ધોઝ થિંગ્સ, વી ફોરગેટ ધ સબસ્ટન્સ ઓફ કમ્યુનિયન. આઈ વોઝ શેરિંગ વિથ વન ઓફ ધ ફ્રેન્ડ્સ યેસ્ટરડે, સમટાઈમ્સ ધ થિંગ્સ બીકમ સો યુઝ્યુઅલ that we don't go into deep of the things, we just look at the surface and we think we know everything. Is it? ઘણી બધી વાર એવું થાય કે એ બધી બાબતો આપણે એટલી બધી વાર જોઈ છે, એટલી બધી વાર કરી છે, then it becomes so normal to us and we don't go in the depth of what it meant for. Is it? So we have time, I have time, you have time. And Jesus comes tomorrow, I'm ready for it and I hope you're ready for it. Is it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. So we're gonna take our time to talk about they devoted themselves in the breaking of bread. They did not break the bread when they had chance or time, but they devoted themselves. And when it says it was important for them to partake in this communion, it was not just one ritual, it was not just one tradition that they had to follow, it was not even something that was just set up for this church and that church, but it was, they were very devoted for that thing. That's what exactly the Bible says, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And that's where I want to focus on today. Praise God. The word communion means a common union. A common union. Praise God. You and I can have common union when we have communion in Christ. Otherwise, we are not blood related. We are not related, kaka, mama, for you, some of us, but not all of us, isn't it? But we have communion because we have a common union in Christ Jesus. So when we have communion with Him, we become one with Him and we become one with each other as well. Hallelujah, praise God. That's the whole purpose of calling it communion. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And I'm going to go to the famous passage of 1 Corinthians, and Jordan and Jill has read for us. Hallelujah, praise God. And I'm going to focus on that. I'm not sure how many times you have heard it. If you're older, then you must have read hundreds of times. If you're young like me, you must have read few times. But you know this passage. This is not a familiar passage. But I want to tell you, sometimes familiarity causes complacency. And we don't want to do that. We want to go as a fresh thing, as Cheryl has prayed. We want to look at a fresh perspective. So verse number 23 says, this is written by, isn't it, Rabbi Shaul. He's writing this, yes. Isn't it? Praise God. And Rabbi Shaul is writing, and he's not going to mince words. The first thing he says, for what I received from the Lord, I give it to you. Are you there? Dev tarafthi je mane madyu, main tamne pan aapi didu. If I remember that, when God gave communion, Saul wasn't there. When Jesus sat on this table in Matthew chapter 26, Saul wasn't there. And that's when I remember the Last Supper and the First Communion started, isn't it? I'm not going to go there, but I'm just trying to remember. That's where Saul was not there. So if John says that, I would believe it because he received it from the Lord. If Matthew says that, I would believe it. If Bartholomew says that, if Philip says that, I would say, okay, yeah, you are saying it right. But Saul says, without being unashamed, he says, what I have received from the Lord, I'm going to give it to you. Isn't it? Praise God. When did he receive it? When did he receive it? And that is the ministry of Lord the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, the Holy Spirit has revealed things to Paul even though he was not there. Lord, the Holy Spirit has taught him things even though he was not present at times, isn't it? Lord, the Holy Spirit has given him so much insight into the Old Testament even though he was not there. And that is why, hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. It is done, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. He did not receive by the word, but he received it by the revelation of the Lord, the Holy Spirit. Amen. See, Lord, the Holy Spirit, we only think of the power as well, right? But Lord, the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth, isn't it? Lord, the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of revelation as well, isn't it? John chapter 16, verse number 13 says, however, when he, the Spirit of truth has come. Everybody says Spirit of truth. If you want to know the truth, I have a guy. Is it? Jimmy called me. Pastor, do you have a guy to fix the car? I said, I don't have a guy to fix the car. But I can tell you, I have a guy who can tell you the truth. The Spirit of the truth. Everybody says Spirit of truth. He's complete truth. And whatever he says is truth. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. If you want to know the truth, we can deceive ourselves. Bible so many times says, Rashmi Bhai has asked a question. I'm not sure anybody answered other than me. But Rashmi Bhai said, what is deception? And the first thing I think deceives is like deceiving ourselves. What if we deceive ourselves? Isn't it? Praise God. But that is why you and I need the Spirit of the truth, which shows us the truth. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Prabhu, a lot of times we see that, but that's not the truth. How will Jesus judge the world? એ પોતાની આંખે જોયા પ્રમાણે તથા પોતાના કાને સાંભળ્યા પ્રમાણે ઇન્સાફ કરશે નહીં. મીન્સ સમટાઇમ્સ યુ સી બટ ધેટ્સ નોટ ધ ટ્રુથ, સમટાઇમ્સ યુ હિયર બટ ધેટ્સ નોટ ધ ટ્રુથ. એન્ડ ધેટ ઇઝ વાય યુ એન્ડ આઈ નીડ લોર્ડ ધ હોલી સ્પિરિટ હુ ઇઝ ધ સ્પિરિટ ઓફ ધ ટ્રુથ. એમેન. હાલેલુયા, પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. થેન્ક યુ જીસસ. હાલેલુયા. સ્પિરિટ ઓફ ધ ટ્રુથ વિલ કમ એન્ડ હી વિલ નોટ સ્પીક ઓફ હિઝ ઓન અથોરિટી, બટ વોટ એવર હી હિયર્સ હી વિલ સ્પીક એન્ડ હી વિલ tell you the things to come. Tell you the things is revelation, which is not known now, but it will be known by you. Amen. Verse number 14, shall I please? He will glorify me, for he will take of what is mine and declare it to you. Lord, the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of revelation. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Definitely, Revelation is the last book of the chapter. Praise God. It is complete revelation of Lord Jesus Christ. But let me tell you, Lord reveals things in your life and my life as well. Lord reveals things. Prabhunu vachan kaje ki jyare pavitra atma aavse tyare e shu karse ghani badi babato tamne kisa. He will talk about judgment. He will talk about sin and he will talk about righteousness. Isn't it? He will talk about it. Hallelujah, praise God. And that is why you and I need the Spirit of the Lord, the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, praise God. Because He is the Spirit of the truth. Hallelujah, praise God. But to hear from Lord, the Holy Spirit, I know I'm dwelling it here. I'm going to talk about communion. But we won't be able to talk about anything other than if you talk about the Holy Spirit, isn't it? Praise God. We want to hear from God. I want to hear from God. You want to hear from God. Hallelujah, praise God. And we would need Lord, the Holy Spirit. But Lord, the Holy Spirit is also got the Spirit of the fear of the Lord. Let me say it again. Let me say Isaiah chapter 11, isn't it? Seven spirits that are mentioned, and the last spirit mentioned is the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of the fear of Dev. Yavana Bhaino Atma. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We will hear from Him when we revere Him as the Most High God. When we not just fear Him as afraid of Him, but when we honor Him. When we very cognizant of His presence in your life and my life. Isn't it? Praise God. Imagine if I invite you to my house, isn't it? And my door is open Wednesday night. Every Wednesday night my door is open because people come in my house. And sometimes I'm not able to greet because Bible study or prayer meeting has started. But let's say other day you come, you ring the bell. Right? I come, I open the door, and I get busy with whatever I was doing. Okay, are we there? I'm going to get busy, do homework with Samara, I'm going to help Mrinal cook, I'm going to do something, whatever. I invited you, I let you get in, but it did not honor you. I did not pay attention to you. I'm sure you would come next time when I ask you to come. I'm sure you would want to talk with me. Isn't it? Praise God. When you have somebody come to your house, no matter what your plans are, your table look like a mess, you put it aside and you attend to them. You share your talk with them. You commune with them. Isn't it? You spend time in their presence. And that's when the communion starts. Amen. So when we come, hallelujah, in the presence of God, we just don't open the door and say, hey, Holy Spirit, come on in. Let me finish what I'm doing and we'll chat. That's not how it's going to work. We need to say, Lord, the Holy Spirit, you know what? I got many things to share. Let's see what you have to share to me. I want to talk to you. I want to experience your presence. I want to have manifestation of your presence in my life. Amen. I want gift, but I'm not going to take a gift right now. But I want you first. And then I also want the gift of the Spirit. I also want the fruit of the Spirit. I want everything what you have to give to me. Amen. Praise God. So I want to tell you right now, let's honor Lord the Holy Spirit. Let's walk in the fear of the Lord for Lord the Holy Spirit as well. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's go back to me. Verse number 23. For I received from the Lord, I also delivered to you. And then he says, the same night that Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread and he broke it and he gave it to people and said, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, this is the cup of the new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let me tell you, who started the communion? So whose plan is it?
Jesus.
Okay, it is God's plan for you and I had to have communion. Lord, when we pay attention on our plans, but let's pay attention on God's plan. Communion is not your plan or my plan. Communion is God's plan for you and me. Communion is God's plan for the body of Christ. Communion is God's plan for his born again sons and daughters so that they can have communion with each other. He says, God says, I'm going to ordain this so that, you know what, I can have communion with you. You can have communion with me. And that is my plan. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Apna plan to bahut nirala hai, isn't it? Bible says, no one searched for God. No one looks after him. There's no note to unrighteous. We never went looking after God. He came chasing after us. Isn't it? Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you. So I'm gonna share a few points right now. Hallelujah. But before I go there, let's open Genesis chapter 14. Utpadinu pustak, 14th adhyay, and 17th adharmi kalam apne kholiye. Somebody read it for me. Gujarat, English, Punjabi, anything is fine. Urdu is fine too. Genesis 14.
17 and
18. Amen. Praise God. Be with me. Are we there? I'm going to go in a little bit faster because I always find there's a lot of things to say in a limited time, isn't it? Praise God, because Bible is so rich. He says, Abraham come from Kedorlaomer. He fought a war. He has released Lot and his family. And when he comes right there, this particular place, which is King's Valley, there are two kings comes. Everybody say two kings.
Yes.
One is the king of Sodom, it comes. Is it? It's the same Sodom that God has destroyed. But in God's graciousness, God delivers King Sodom's king by the hand of Abraham. And he comes and he says, you know what? You can have everything what you want. Just give me the man. Isn't it? Then there's another king came. The king of Salem. Where is the Salem? The word Salem comes from the word Shalom, isn't it? And then the new word is the Jerusalem, isn't it? Praise God. The king of Salem came and he was also the priest of Most High God. Hallelujah. Praise God. And he brought something else. He brought bread and wine. He brought bread and wine. Let me tell you, only he can bring bread and wine because he is the priest of Most High God. The communion was given to Abraham by the priesthood of Melchizedek. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. So the first thing I want to give it to you, that Christ, our high priest, invites us to have communion. Not just Christ the Lamb, but Christ, our high priest. Hallelujah. Because see, Levitical priesthood is not a Levitical priest. He is the Melchizedek na dhara pramanite aplo. Sanatak prabhu. If you want to know what Melchizedek, we can have a separate study. Hallelujah. Praise God. But he is a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek. And high priest gives communion, delivers communion. Not in the church, but delivers communion. And that is how Lord Jesus Christ has invited you and me as a high priest to this communion table. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. See, God invites. Isn't it? Praise God. Let me tell you one best thing about Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus goes wherever he is invited. Simon the leper invites, he's there. Matthew invites him, he goes there as well, tax collector's house. Whoever invites him, he will go. Isn't it? Hallelujah. But then he also gives invitation cards to people. Isn't it? Thank you, Jesus. The invitation card number one is, come follow me. Isn't it? I'm sure you got it. And I hope you responded to it. Amen. Praise God. Thank you. Second thing he said, not just come follow me. He said, come follow me so I will also give you abundant life. If you're my sheep, hear me and follow me as well. Hallelujah. So there are many invitations Lord Jesus Christ gives. And this is one of the invitation of high priest so that we can partake with him in this very sacred table of Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. So number one point, we have to remember that. Hallelujah. That it is Christ our high priest who invites us to the table of communion. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. He broke the bread and he said, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in the remembrance of me. Amen. Praise God. Jesus is complete truth. And another truth is not very good to hear. You know, disciples said, ke Prabhu, aa vaato kitli kathan chhe. Isn't it? That's what they said. Exactly, that's what it says. Ke these are hard things to hear. Isn't it? Praise God. But it was complete truth. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Let me tell you, he did not speak truth in anger. Bible says, with him grace and truth also came. So he always spoke truth in grace. Even though he was upset about things, but it was grace of God that he wanted to correct them. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. So come back. Let me come back. So in Gospel according to John, he gives some statements. And people say, whoa. Is it? Who can say that? Is it? World is still saying woe to it. How can be there's only one way to God? Jesus said, I am the way to God. Take it or leave it. Isn't it? Praise God. So in that, Jesus says, I am the living bread, which has come down from the heaven. Hallelujah. Let's open John chapter 6. Yone lakari swada eno chatto adhyay ani 51 mi kalav apde vaachiye je jeevti
rotli akash mathi utri che te hu chu jo koi e rotli khay to te sada jeevto rahese vadi je rotli hu aapish te maru mas che.
Okay je rotli hu aapise su che
maru mas
che. Everybody say flesh.
Flesh.
It's not a good sign if you visualize it. But let me say, Jesus does not have to say good things to you. Jesus has to say true things to you. Amen. Praise God. Jesus said, the bread that I give it to you is my flesh. Hallelujah. Praise God. Read for the Christy.
Te jagatna jivan ne saru
hu aapis. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Jesus is the bread of life. And those who have received Lord Jesus Christ have received the bread of life. And this bread of life is not for a day. This is not for a month. It's not for a week. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Physical bread sustains for a day. You had a breakfast in the morning. Now you're hungry. If you can have a dinner in the evening, you can have hungry in the morning. But the bread that Jesus gives, hallelujah, praise God. It is not for just one day, but it is not just sustaining, hallelujah. But it is for your this lifetime and lifetime to come as well. Yeah. Hallelujah, praise God. Yeah. Physical bread sustains for little, but the bread of Lord Jesus Christ sustains us forever. Hallelujah. And it not only sustains us, but he makes us victorious and more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. The bread of life of Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah, praise God, he makes all our spiritual hungers satisfied in him. The bread of life makes all our emotional hunger satisfied in Christ Jesus. This bread of life, hallelujah, grants us abundant life. And Jesus says, let me tell you what is the bread of life. It is my flesh. It is my flesh. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Whenever we partake in the Lord's table, whenever you take up the bread, rotli, wafer, whatever you want to take it as a bread, you're just taking a bread. But it symbolizes Lord's body, which was given for you and me. Amen. Now, when you think like that, now this communion has a lot more significance than just eating wafer and drinking a cup. Amen. When you pick up that thing, you just think about it. You hold that bread into your hand and think, this is your body that was broken for me. And you're allowing me to be partaker of that body. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Christ not only invites us to the table of communion, but Christ also offers us to partake in his body and in his blood through communion. Hallelujah, praise God. Be with me, I'm going to tell you a few things which will make sense. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. John chapter 6, much here. Let's read verse number 55. Isn't it? He says, it's my flesh and it's my blood. Eating, idea of eating flesh and drinking blood is not great idea, isn't it? But Jesus saying, that's the only way you can I have communion. By partaking in my body, by partaking in my flesh, and by partaking in my blood. Hallelujah, praise God. Let's read next verse, verse number 56. Oh, now this is amazing. Praise God. He says, whoever eats my flesh, I will be in him. And he will be in me. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Christ in me, hope of glory. Praise God. Prabhu, the only way we can have communion is through this communion ceremony. This is not just a symbolic ceremony, but this is a ceremony that pictures our communion with him, that he is in us and we are in him. Hallelujah. This is very powerful. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. These are just the physical element. Hallelujah. But even if this physical element, we think with reverence. Hallelujah. We will understand the importance of it. He says, why do we need physical elements like that? Isn't it? Cannot we have spiritually Lord's body and spiritually Lord's blood? Can we not have spiritual communion? Let me tell you, a lot of physical manifestation have spiritual meaning behind it. Isn't it? Are we there?
Yes.
Hallelujah. The book of Genesis says, the man shall leave his father and mother. Okay. And they shall be one?
Flesh.
Say it again.
Flesh.
If God will say, they shall be one spirit. Isn't it? We would like that. Isn't it? God's idea is more beautiful than what you and I can think. They shall be one?
Flesh.
It means, hallelujah, praise God. God says, there is whatever I am binding spiritually has a physical manifestation of it. Isn't it? Even though what you made a covenant in the presence of God, there is a physical manifestation of it. And physical manifestation is, you shall be one flesh. The same way, when Jesus has died for you and me, we have received him by faith. This is a physical manifestation of his sacrifice, his communion, his body, his blood. And when we are partaking in that, we become one with him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. When New Testament church did it, this is what they thought. They did not worry about wafer, isn't it? They did not worry about some churches drink from the same cup, and I don't have problem against it, but then we are focusing on what we are going to pee, isn't it? Isn't it? And we tend to start focusing on wrong things. But when New Testament church partake in communion, this is what they thought. They look at Lord Jesus Christ, they would have a picture of Lord bloody body of Lord Jesus Christ, the shed blood of Lord Jesus Christ, says, we are partaking in him. He in me, I in him. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, praise God. The union is through covenant, but a physical manifestation of union is very important. The same way we have received Jesus Christ, we continue to abide in the true mind, and the communion is the physical manifestation. Hallelujah, praise God. Let me tell you, it's not just physical as well. There's always a spiritual strength behind it. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. We talk about that once you're born again, you should be baptized, isn't it? I'm not about confirmation. I'm not talking about anything else. We don't baptize little children, but we give you privilege to decide when you are born again to receive that baptism. And some of us have been very gracious to help me to be in the water with me to baptize individuals. And when we baptize them, those who've been baptized, they would remember. We baptize them, we hold them up, and we invoke what Bible says. When we put them in water, Bible, we say that, buried with Christ, raised with Christ, right? We're not buried anyway, isn't it? But that action signifies that our old self has been buried. We've been crucified. We are no longer there. But now when we come out, we have a new life in Lord Jesus Christ. And that is why you and I can say, I once was dead, but now I live. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. The same way, hallelujah, when we partake in this communion, we are communing with his body, with his blood. Hallelujah, praise God. So Christ abides in us. Hallelujah. And we in him through communion. That is my third point. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Fourth thing I want to say right now. Let's go back to verse number 16. 1 Corinthians chapter 10. So 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse number 16. Only first part of it. Okay, stop right there. Piala seno che?
Ashirvad.
And we say cup of blessing.
Cup of blessing.
When we partake in this, that's a cup of?
Blessing.
Let's say it again, cup of blessing.
Cup of blessing.
It's just not a grape juice from Welch company anymore. It is a cup of?
Blessings.
It means when I partake in that cup, I have blessings. Amen. He said, if it is a cup of blessing, it will give me blessing when I'm partaking in that. If it is a cup of blessing, I would receive blessings because it is called cup of blessing. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. So I'm going to talk about some blessing of that cup right now. Hallelujah, praise God. So the fourth point, the Christ blesses us through communion. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Let's open John chapter 6 once again. We're going to go back to John, Corinthians, and Genesis. Okay, that's how we're going to move. John chapter 6, verse number
54.
We have blessing. It is a cup of blessing. Hallelujah. We will have eternal life and we'll be raised again. That is assurance in Christ Jesus when we are partaking in this cup. Hallelujah. Praise God. But I'm going to mention five blessings right now. Hallelujah. Let's go back to Genesis. Genesis chapter 9, verse number 4. Yes, please. Okay, so verse 3-4. Yeah. A lot of people are saying amen right now. Isn't it?
Na
khasho, isn't it? My English translation says, you shall not eat the flesh with his life. That's okay. With his life. Everybody say with his life.
With his life.
And life is in the blood. Life is in the blood. Okay, let's read one verse which is more clear. Book of Leviticus, chapter 17. Verse number 11. And the first part says, for the life of the flesh is in the if you want to talk about life, the life is in the blood. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. All right, Raktadan, Mahadan. We used to say that, isn't it? Right, Basco AMTS, I'm not sure still there, but that's what they at least used to say. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. He says, the life of the flesh is in the blood. Hallelujah, praise God. Now be with me. Let's go back to Old Testament. આપણે ફરોસીનોને સદુકીનો કોટ પહેરી લઈએ આપણે જસ્ટ ફોર ધ મોમેન્ટ ઓકે એન્ડ નાઉ યુ હિયર ધીસ ઓલ યોર લાઈફ દેટ લાઈફ ઓફ ધ ફ્લેશ ઇઝ ઇન ધ બ્લડ એન્ડ ધેન જીસસ કમ એન્ડ સેઝ ઈટ માય ફ્લેશ ડ્રિંક માય બ્લડ હી સેડ ધેટ્સ નોટ કોશર વી આર નોટ સપોઝ ટુ ઈટ લાઈક ધેટ ઇઝન્ટ ઇટ Bible says in John chapter 6, if you read further, lot of disciples left him. Lot of disciples left him. I want to encourage you for this point. Lot of disciples left him because they did not understand fullness of the word of God in Lord Jesus Christ. Lot of times we do not understand the fullness of what Jesus is saying and we leave that on the side. Hallelujah. But let me tell you, the worst mistake that you and I can make is to ignore the word of Lord Jesus Christ, even if we don't understand it. We pay attention to it, we pay heed to it, we ask the help of Lord, the Holy Spirit, and we ask it, Lord, teach me, I don't understand it. We become like that father, isn't it? Fellow father, he comes to Lord Jesus Christ, says, Lord, my daughter, Lord. Anything for my daughter. Come on, Lord. Like, can you please do something? Jesus says, all things are possible for those who believe. Father is not going to pretend because he's not a Pharisee. Isn't it? He's going to say, Lord, my faith is not that much as well. Increase my faith, Lord. Increase my faith. That's the right prayer to pray. Isn't it? Prabhu, yaar, atlo vishwas ne kala hai ispachi. Lord, we just ignore what Jesus says because we don't understand it. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, let's spend time in the Word of God. Let's ask Lord the Holy Spirit and He will teach you. A lot of people start following Lord Jesus Christ when He said this statement in John chapter 6. Hallelujah. Let me get back. Hallelujah. Praise God. The life is in the blood. And Jesus says, drink my blood. Drink the life that is in the blood. So when you partake in that communion, symbolically, what you are doing, the life that is in the blood of Lord Jesus Christ, you're receiving that life for yourself. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Anybody has received blood when you have broke your head? Or like anybody has received any blood transfusion? No? Anybody has given blood? Okay. We all have given blood. Did you give blood to anybody? No? So they said, okay, we're going to do the blood group testing. Isn't it? A, B, A, B, O, whatever it is. Rh positive, Rh negative. Isn't it? Right? Everything we test. And then we do a coagulation test. And we make sure it matches. And then once it matches, we will give a blood transfusion to individual. Why blood transfusion is needed? Is it? The medicine science has advanced so much. Why can't they figure it out something other way? Why you need blood? And why you need somebody else's blood? Why can't you make your own blood? Isn't it? Because life is in the blood. You can't make it. It is a gift from God given to you and me. Amen. Hallelujah. So when you give a blood transfusion, you're giving an opportunity for another person to live.
Yes.
The life that is in your blood, now it has been transferred to some other person as well. Hallelujah. That is our physical blood transfusion. Let me tell you, Jesus is talking about some spiritual blood transfusion right now. He said, when you partake in this cup, you are getting blood of Lord Jesus Christ into your life. And this blood is not a sinful blood. This blood has no sin at all. This blood is a pure blood. This blood is without spot, without blemish. And this blood has life. And that is life abundant. So when you and I partake in that blood, hallelujah, praise God, we receive the same life that was in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Same life. Hallelujah. See, God doesn't give us second-hand things when we walk in righteousness and follow Him by faith. Isn't it? He gives exactly same thing what He has promised. Isn't it? Moses said, you have to get pure blood. No, you're going to get the same life. Same Holy Spirit. Which Holy Spirit? Same. What do you mean same? The same Holy Spirit that rose Jesus Christ from the dead dwells in you. No other spirit. Same Lord, the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of power, the Spirit of manifestation, Spirit of wisdom, Spirit of understanding, Spirit of the fear of the Lord. The same Spirit that was upon Lord Jesus Christ been gifted to you and me. The same blood that was shed on that cross, which was sinless. The same blood that stands in the presence of God into the Holy of Holies by Lord the Holy Spirit, by the high priest, the same blood has been offered to you to partake in that blood so that you and I have life. So that you and I have life. The word for life is Zoe, isn't it? And that's an abundant life. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We say get a life, isn't it? To a lot of people. We need to tell. Anyways, okay. All right, let's go back. Let's go back. So when you receive, when you take communion today, I want to encourage you and I want to encourage myself. We're going to pray and ask for repentance and so many things. But I'm going to pray, Lord, I receive the life that is in your blood. I receive Zoe life. I receive abundant life. I receive the life that heals me, that provides for me, that takes care of me, and that makes me like Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, praise God. So when we partake today, we're going to partake like that. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. So this is, hallelujah, praise God. I'm going to go back. Hallelujah. Christ bless us through communion. The number one blessing is, it is a life blood. Everybody say life blood. Hallelujah, praise God. Second thing I'm going to say, I'm going to move forward. I have many things to cover. When your blood was shed and my blood shed, what happens? It coagulates. Isn't it? Scientific bashama. Isn't it? And then it is of no use.
Yes.
When you give blood, I worked in a blood bank and a lot of you have worked in the blood bank. The moment you receive the blood, bag me in the chemicals, so they keep it liquid and they separate blood, plasma, RBC, WBC, they separated everything and then they use it. Jesus Christ, na blood never kisi jarur nahi. Even though it was shed 2,000 years ago, it is the still same life. It is not coagulated. It is not become useless. It has the same power that He had 2,000 years ago. The power to defeat enemy, the power to defeat every sin, power to defeat every hell. And Jesus said, I offer that power to you so that you can also have life. હાલેલુયા. પ્રભુનું વચન કેવી રીતે કહી શકે આપણને તમને કે તમે મારા જેવા કામ કરશો? જીસસ હાઉ? રાઈટ, હી સેડ બીકોઝ યુ આર ધ સેમ લાઈફ, યુ આર ધ સેમ હોલી સ્પિરિટ, યુ આર ધ સેમ વર્ડ, યુ હેવ એક્ઝેક્ટલી સેમ થિંગ વિચ આઈ હેડ. હાલેલુયા. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. So it is a lifeblood. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Second thing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse number 25.
Ech pramane bhojan karya pachi tene pyalo lido ane kahyu ke aa pyalo mara raktma navo karar che.
Aa pyalo mara raktma su che?
Navo karar.
Everybody say navo karar.
Navo karar
is not New Testament. It is a new covenant. Isn't it? Praise God. Testament and covenant are the same word, but somehow the canonized people, they thought to give that name. But actually it is a new covenant, isn't it? The old covenant was Sinai covenant, old covenant was Abrahamic covenant. But Jesus said, I am making a new covenant with you. That is why from Matthew 2, and Revelation is called New Testament or a new covenant. Amen. Let's go to Matthew chapter 26. And it is the Last Supper, First Communion. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I'm excited. Chapter 26, verse number 28. Okay, now it's a little bit different. A raktma navo karar che, but Jesus says, this is my blood of the new covenant. This is my blood of the
new covenant.
It is not only a life blood, but it is also a covenant blood. Everybody say covenant blood.
Covenant.
Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. God makes covenant. And God also establishes covenants in your life and my life. If you're husband and wife, because you have made a covenant with me. If you and I are in the kingdom of God, because God has made a covenant with you. Hallelujah, praise God. And that covenant, hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. When God has made a covenant with you, that covenant was sealed in not in the blood of the lamb or blood of the bull, but the covenant was sealed in the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Just for 1 second, what is the covenant blood? Isn't it? Whenever in the old time covenant was made, the covenant has to be sealed. It means confirm karanu, isn't it? When you go to bank, you write a paper and you sign it. That is your seal. Because if you don't pay, they're going to follow you. Isn't it? I'm not your guarantor. Nobody's my guarantor as well. Isn't it? But you make a sign and that becomes a seal of that covenant. That you're abiding by that agreement, isn't it? Isn't it? So God, when God makes a covenant, he also put a seal on it. He gives a sign for it. Isn't it? Praise God. Prabhu Ibrahim ne kidu ke every male child in your household shall be circumcised on the 8th day, and that shall be a sign of covenant. It means you would know that you are in my covenant, and I would know that you are in my covenant. Amen. Praise God. Prabhu Noah ne kidu ke whenever you shall see a Ishu Dhanusha in the sky, isn't it? It is a sign of a covenant. Isn't it? That I will not destroy the earth again. Isn't it? It's a sign of a covenant. Isn't it? Praise God. The same way Jesus says, my blood has made a seal on your covenant. Hallelujah. Praise God. And when he has made a seal, it means covenant has many things in it. Number one thing covenant has promises. Isn't it? Prabhu Ibrahim has a covenant. Prabhu has 7 promises. Isn't it? And those are big promises. Still, they have never run out of it. Hallelujah. Praise God. When God has made a covenant with you, when you receive Lord Jesus Christ, by the forgiveness of your sin, repentance of the sin, God has made a covenant with you. And that covenant is made in the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. When he has made that covenant with you, isn't it? Let's just lighten up, isn't it? You also made a covenant, isn't it? Huh? Yeah, હા હું એ પ્રમાણે કરીશ એટલું જ યાદ છે કારણ કે બાકી બધું પાદરી સાહેબ બોલ્યા હતા isn't it? Everything else what he said. હા હું એ પ્રમાણે કરીશ કોણે સાંભળ્યું છે looking at your bride isn't it? સાંભળજો next time જેનો વારો છે અને આખું કહેજો isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Covenant had a promise. સુખમાને માંદગી માને યસ આઈ વિલ બી ધેર ટિલ ધેટ ડુ અસ વી મેડ અ પ્રોમિસ એવરી કવેનન્ટ હેઝ અ પ્રોમિસ વેન ગોડ મેડ અ કવેનન્ટ વિથ યુ ગોડ ઓલ્સો પ્રોમિસ્ડ યુ સમથિંગ ઇફ યોર હ્યુમન કવેનન્ટ સેઝ આઈ વિલ બી વિથ યુ ટિલ ધેટ ડુ યુ અપાર્ટ જીસસ વેન હી મેડ અ કવેનન્ટ હી સેઝ જગતના અંત સુધી હું તારી સાથે છું ધેટ્સ માય કવેનન્ટ વિથ યુ. Hallelujah, praise God. According to 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse number 20 says, all promises of God are yes and amen in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Because he has made a covenant with you. We become very stingy about using God's promises. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. New Testament has 750 promises. How many? God has promised you 750 promises in the Old New Testament alone. If you're being very legalistic about New Testament, let me tell you, Old Testament has more than double the promises in that. Hallelujah, praise God. Hallelujah. Abraham na bhi blessing apna mate yes and amen che, because my Lord has made a covenant with me. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. My Lord has made a covenant with me, and that is why he has said he will deliver you from your enemy. One time, two time, it's a covenant. He will deliver you with your enemy. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. My Bible says he will also deliver you from coronavirus. Marki tara tambuni paase aavse. Hallelujah. Praise God. Daade utnar tirthi ke ratre je dasti lage chhe. Tenethi Yehovah taru rakshan karse. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Because he has made a covenant with you and me. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We a lot of time meditate on our problems. Isn't it? Prabhu, meditate karona kidu dos. But not on the problem. Meditate on his promises. Meditate on his word. Meditate on his correction. Meditate on his character. That's what you and I meditate upon. Isn't it? And age by age, Psalm 91 of Prabhu no vachan kaya jai, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Whatever happens around you, isn't it? I will deliver you. The Lord shall be your strength and your buckler. And he will deliver you from all your enemies. Why will he deliver you? Because he has made a covenant with you. Amen. Why would he take care of you? Because he has made a covenant with you. Why he will provide for you? Because he has made a covenant with you. Why he will listen to you? Because he has made a covenant with you. Why he will answer your prayers? Because he has made a covenant with you, and that covenant was sealed in the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. It is not only a life blood, but it is also a covenant blood. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Third thing. Hallelujah. Let's go to Exodus. Praise God. Exodus chapter 20. Old Testaments are the fair shade of the things to come. Juno Karar. E avnar vastuno parchhaya hoti, isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Is that the one? Exodus 20? Okay. Let me say that right. Just one second. Sorry, Exodus chapter 12. Sorry about that, Shella. Exodus 12:7.
અને તેના રક્તમાંથી લઈને જે ઘરોમાં તેઓ તે ખાય તેમની બંને બારસાખો ઉપર તથા ઉત્તરમ ઉપર તેઓ છાંટે.
Isn't it? So you should take the. We know this is the feast of Passover. This is the first Passover. It was done in the Goshen in Egypt. And God says, you shall take a lamb or a bull or whatever size of your family is. And once you sacrifice that lamb, you take the hyssop and dip it in the blood and cover it in the doorpost and the lintel of the house. Isn't it? That's what you do. Okay. verse number 13 of the same chapter. Okay. Rakta su thase? The blood shall be a sign upon your house. Everybody say sign. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Blood shall be a sign. Be with me. Let's visualize this. Okay. You and I are living in Goshen, our house. There is a big Hebrew letter Tau. T-A-W. That's how it says. A doorpost and lentils, the blood of the lamb is there. And Bible says God is sending an angel of the death and goes around the city, and there will be death in every household. Every household in Egypt, every out of the Goshen. But when he comes around, before he enters this house, he sees the blood of the lamb. Isn't it? Right? Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Let's read that verse. Okay, I'm going to read this verse. Now the blood shall be a sign for you in the houses where you are. And when I see the blood, who says? God says. He says, when I see the blood, I will pass over. When I see the blood over your life, I will pass over. Isn't it? And then he says, and the plague shall not be on you to destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. Isn't it? Plague jo Egyptian par aaya, e tamara par nahi aave, because you have protecting blood on the doorpost and lintels of your household. Amen. Hallelujah. If that blood which was of the lamb was able to protect Israelites there, this is the blood of the sinless lamb of God. when you and I partake in this blood. Hallelujah, praise God. We invoke the protection of Lord Jesus Christ over our life. Amen. Hallelujah, praise God. I'm not sure who needs protection, but I need protection because I live in Brampton. Isn't it? If you're driving on 401, you need protection. Isn't it? If you're living in basement, you need protection. Wherever you are, you and I need protection. Hallelujah. And let me tell you, that is our protection. Our protection is in the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. It is a protecting blood. Thank you, Jesus. We're still talking about blessing, okay? Luke chapter 24, verse number 30 and 31. And I give this message in the series Empty Tomb to Open Heaven, yes. Road to Emmaus. Okay. Now it came to pass, and he sat at the table with them. And he took bread and blessed it and gave it to them. Verse number 31. And their eyes were opened. Everybody say opened.
Open.
They're walking with Jesus for 7 miles to Emmaus. They don't know who Jesus is. They don't know who this person is. He said, the moment Jesus took the bread and broke it, my Bible says, and your Bible says the same thing, their eyes were? It is a revealing blood. When you come and partake of the table of the Lord, it reveals things of Lord Jesus Christ that you're not known before. You can see Jesus is in a greater light which you've not seen him before. Hallelujah. These people were his disciples. They have walked with Jesus. They have seen Jesus doing miracles. The moment they received the communion, their eyes were opened up. Hallelujah. I am not just stretching this blessing right now, but this is exactly what my Bible says. Their eyes were opened up. Hallelujah. Praise God. It is also a revealing blood. Hallelujah. It is a revealing blood. Thank you, Jesus. Fifth blessing of the blood. I have still many things to cover. Be with me. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. 1 John 1, 7. 1 John 1, 7. They just read it. All the children just said, if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and blood of Lord Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from his sin, from all his sin. If we say cleanses. We all took nice shower today. I hope everybody did it. Isn't it? Whatever you use, it's Dove, Old Spice, whatever it is, right? Yeah. It worked. It cleansed you. You're going to need it tomorrow as well. Maybe you need it in the evening as well. And you will need it pretty much every single day to cleanse your physical body. Isn't it? The same way our spirit gets defiled. Because we stumble upon. We fall. I'm not talking about sin and rebellion. We are talking about stumbling only, okay? I'm not talking about sin and rebellion right now. Because sin and rebellion has a different thing I have to say. But when we stumble upon, we also need cleansing of our spirits. And that cleansing comes through the blood of Lord Jesus Christ only. Isn't it? But Pastor, I'm born again. I have received the blood of Jesus Christ when I was born again. This is written for born again people. This is written for the church of Lord Jesus Christ. John is talking to the church and he says, hallelujah, when you commit a sin, go to Lord Jesus Christ and he will cleanse you from the sin. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. It is also a cleansing blood. And I want to tell you right now, praise God. Thank you. When you're going to come and partake in the cup and the bread, you can ask for forgiveness and many things I'm going to still talk about. But ask God to cleanse us. Isn't it? Because most of the spiritual defilement, only he can clean it. Isn't it? Even though we have asked for forgiveness, he still need to clean it. Amen? Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Okay. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to skip to one point. He says, I'm going to go to 1 Corinthians chapter 11 once again. Hallelujah. Do this in remembrance of me. So whenever we take communion, we remember Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Verse number 26. As often as you eat this bread and drink this crust, you proclaim Lord's death till he comes. Hallelujah. What do you do? You? Everybody say proclaim.
Proclaim.
When we proclaim in the church, it's not a wrong thing. Because the Bible says you proclaim. What is proclamation? Manma proclamation na hoy. Isn't it? What is proclamation? Come on. You speak it out. We leave it out loud. Isn't it? Like my every hashtag would be proclaiming Lord's death. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you. He said, when you're communing right now, when you partake in the communion, you know what you're doing? Hallelujah. Praise God. You're proclaiming Lord's death. And not Lord's death that Jesus has died, but Lord's death that Jesus has died for me. Isn't it? Jesus has died for
me.
me. Hallelujah, praise God. So when you partake in that, let your mouth proclaim that Jesus has died for me. Because we are supposed to do that, isn't it? Jesus has died for me. And let your ears hear that. Let your body hear that. Let the powers of darkness hear that. That Jesus has died for you. Hallelujah. Jesus has died for me. And I'm going to proclaim that. Hallelujah. And I'm going to also proclaim, I'm loved because Jesus has died for me. Hallelujah. I'm healed because Jesus has taken those stripes for me. I'm provided for because he has blessed me with every blessing through the cross of Calvary. I am his son. I am his daughter. And sin has no dominion over me. That is my proclamation when I partake in communion. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. How long are we going to do the proclamation? Till he? Most of you are here, so he hasn't come yet. Isn't it? Right? So you can continue doing this till he comes. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Now, communion has so many blessings, but communion comes with a warning. Isn't it? Most of the pastors talk about warning. I'm going to talk about warning as well, but not as much as people spend their life on warning. We're going to talk about warning as well. Let's go to the next point. You're not even examining your neighbor or your friend or your family member. But you and I must need to examine ourselves. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And this is so profound. When we examine ourselves, we will not take it in an unworthy manner. What has happened? Satan has put a twist on it. And say, you know what? If there is something you're unworthy, don't take it. No. Now, nothing says in this passage that don't take it. It says don't take it in an unworthy manner. Isn't it? It means become worthy to take it. And you know what? What makes you worthy? When you examine yourself. When I examine myself. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. What is an unworthy manner? Hallelujah. Unworthy manner is unrepented sins in your life, in my life. Unworthy manner is resentfulness. Unworthy manner is rebellion. Unworthiness is disobedience to the word of God. Unrebellion, what God has already told us, clarified us, proclaimed in our lives multiple times, but still not obeyed. That is unworthy manner. Hallelujah. Praise God. The sin that we have become victorious over once, but now we are still succumbed to it. Whatever it is, maybe a theft, maybe an anger, maybe a lust, whatever it is, that's unworthiness. Hallelujah. Praise God. No reverence to the Lord is also unworthiness. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Sin in our heart and mind is unworthiness. Isn't it? Hallelujah. We need to deal with it when we come to the table of the Lord. Isn't it? Let me tell you. It is the grace of God that he gives us the opportunity to examine ourselves so that we can come and get cleansed. Isn't it? I heard Christian Kane or some of the pastors says, he says, we become so guilty when we have confessed the sin. But he says, think it like that. Till you did not confess the sin was in the darkness. The sin was in the darkness. You're not dealing with it. God can't deal with it, but you're still in the darkness. But the moment you confess it, then now you have brought sin into the light of the word of God. You have brought the sin into the light of Lord Jesus Christ. Now, once it is brought into light, God can deal with it. God can forgive you. God can cleanse you. God can deal with you. And you and I can be freed from that sin. Hallelujah. Praise God. But we put it under the carpet. Nobody knows. Yeah, nobody need to know. Only he needs to know. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I tell you one thing. And I'm telling with humility because I'm sailing in the same boat that you and I are sailing. Isn't it? I'm standing 6 feet, 6 inches high. It doesn't mean that I'm pious and righteous. Isn't it? I need to repent of my sin as well. But let me tell you, this is an important principle because we become so used to this, we don't even realize how important it is for us to examine ourselves. Isn't it? Right? If you live in apartment or in houses, I have bed bugs in my house. Right now, currently. Isn't it not scaring you? I'm being treated right now. But when the first bed bug came out, we killed it. Then some other day, 10, 15 came out. We put all the batches in the sterile cycle, heat it for 2 hours, 3 hours, and we thought we dealt with it. After 15 days, they still came out. Because I was only treating the symptoms of bad bug. But there was infestation somewhere else, which I have not dealt with. A lot of time we deal with the symptoms of the sin into our life, but there's an infestation, there's an infection, there's a gangrene, we are not dealing with it. I'm telling it in a very humble manner. We must need to deal with it. We must need to deal with it. Otherwise, we will be not worthy to partake in the table of the Lord. And you know how do we deal with it? You know what I'm going to go to the bed bugs? I have called an exterminator. Exterminator is going to fumigate my house with deadly chemicals. She almost got caught into it the other day. He's going to use 65 degrees Celsius steam to steam my entire house. So not only a living bed bug, a dead bug bug, an egg of a bed bug, or any sign of bed bug remains. It has to be completely exterminated. The same way, if there is sin and rebellion outside, there is infection inside, you and I have to bring it to Lord Jesus Christ. He is the best exterminator. He can destroy it, he can kill it, and he can deal with it completely. Hallelujah, praise God. And he can make you and me complete righteous. My Bible says the blood of Lord Jesus Christ cleanses from all unrighteousness. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. But we must to deal with it. Hallelujah, praise God. One more thing I'm going to say. One more. Praise God. Thank you. And I'm saying that with the fear of the Lord in my heart. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. The longer it takes, harder it becomes. Let me say it again. The longer we take to deal with it, harder it becomes. I found out an issue 3 months ago. I didn't deal with it right away. I thought it's only surface issue. Now I have infection in my one of the room. I have to deal with it very hard way. The hard way is I am cleansing all my house, all clothes. Everything has to be cleansed. It is very hard. It's not easy. It's going to cost a lot of money as well. A lot of time what happened? The sin already God has told us. And God talks to us through His Holy Spirit, through His Word, through His people, through His pastors. God speaks to us. But when we don't deal with it, one time, two time, or three time, and a four time, now what happens? We have gone so far, it won't be easy to come back. I'm not saying it's impossible, but it's not easy now. It's become hard now. You have to make really hard to come back. And during this time, Satan is continuing to deceive you and distract you and say everything is all right. It becomes harder and harder and harder for you and me to come back. Thank God for the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. Thank God for the living word of God that every month we read this word. He says, examine ourselves. And we must need to examine. We don't put it on a shelf. I'm going to deal with it. This is not Diwali na vasul ke varash mein kaj vahat gaswana cha. You see? We need to deal with it right away. We need to bring it. Otherwise, it's going to cause an infection. Infection causes gangrene. Gangrene has to be dealt with amputation. Isn't it? We don't want to get amputation done. Let's deal with it when it is still fresh. Amen? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Prabhu Vachan kaise? Can you remember my death? You look back. Till He comes, look forward and examine yourself. Look inside. Look inside. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. When Nathan stood up in the presence of King David and he poked his bony finger in David's face and told him, David, you are that man. Let me tell you, it was not the judgment of God. It was the grace of God. It was the grace of God to tell him that you have sinned, David. Better repent. When Lord the Holy Spirit reveals the sin in your life and my life, it is the grace of God. Otherwise, He has all the right to judge you and me. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Sometimes we are so used to it that, you know what, we didn't pay attention. Say, oh, this is not encouraging. This is not uplifting. This is making me feel guilty. It's not about that. Hallelujah. Praise God. It is the grace of God that God is asking us to repent. God is asking us to reconcile. God is asking us to let go of the offenses. God is asking us to let go of the anger. And God is asking us to let go of the lust. God is asking us to learn what He's teaching. And Lord is asking us to obey what He's already taught. Hallelujah. And this is Lord's request to you and me. It is my request to you and me. Hallelujah. Praise God. This is the most powerful tool of reconciliation between you and God. When you come to the table of the Lord. Isn't it? Reconciliation is a hard process. But God gave you this table. God gave you His blood, His body, so that you and I can come and reconcile. Lord, I messed up. Lord, I harbored this. I come to your table. I examine myself. And sometimes if we can't see anything, let me tell you, pray the prayer David prayed. David says, save me from the presumptuous sin. And if there is hidden in my heart, reveal it to me. You see, David says, you know, I know everything, I'm bringing it to you, but if there is something that I don't know, I don't want to keep it there. You bring it out, Lord. You bring it out. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I want to encourage my brothers and sisters. We want to take this communion differently. There are only three ordinances God has given in the New Testament. The ordinance of baptism, ordinance of communion, and ordinance of feet washing. And those are the three ordinances debated, argued upon so many times rather than obeyed. Isn't it? I want to challenge you. I want to challenge myself. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm going to ask right now Rashmi Bhai and Ivan to come forward. Please help me with the communion. I'll request choir to lead us into the song. And I would say, when the communion, I want you to come and take the communion. Come with a prayerful heart. Come with the prayers that we've been talking about. Ask Lord's grace upon you and me. And when you go back, don't take communion. We pray together. We're going to take communion together. Is that right? But thank you, Jesus. While we are getting ready, I'm going to ask Rashmi Bhai to pray and thank God for His body and His blood. Thank you, Jesus.
સ્વર્ગે સ્વર્ગમાં અમારા જીવન પરમેશ્વર પિતા પ્રભુ શ્રી કૃષ્ણના નામમાં પ્રભુ શ્રી કૃષ્ણના રક્તથી તમારા ચરણોમાં આવીએ છીએ મારા દેવ તમારા નામને માન મહિમા સ્તુતિ અને ગૌરવ આપીએ છીએ મારા પ્રભુ તમે એકલા જીવતા પવિત્ર ઈશ્વર છો મારા દેવ તમારા નામને માન મહિમા સ્તુતિ અને ગૌરવ આપીએ છીએ પ્રભુ સ્વભાવ સઘળી દ્રશ્ય અને અદ્રશ્ય વસ્તુઓ બનાવનાર તમે છો મારા દેવ તમે મહાન ઈશ્વર છો મારા પ્રભુ અને તમારા પ્રેમને માટે તમારો આભારને ઉપકાર માનીએ છીએ મારા દેવ કે જ્યારે અમે પાપી હતા ત્યારે ખ્રિસ્ત તમારા સારું મરણ પામ્યા તમારો આભારને ઉપકાર માનીએ છીએ મારા દેવ કે અમારી પાપી અવસ્થા તમે નિહાળી ત્યારે પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ તમે અમને કન્ડેમ ના કર્યા અમને જજ ના કર્યા મારા દેવ પરંતુ તમારા દીકરાને પાપી દેહની સમાનતામાં મોકલી આપ્યો કે જેથી કરીને અમે જે નાશના માર્ગે જઈ રહ્યા હતા તે પ્રભુ બાપ અમે બચી જઈએ તમારો આભારને ઉપકાર માનીએ તેટલો ઓછો છે મારા દેવ તમારા પ્રેમની એ ગહનતા પ્રભુ સ્વભાવ તમારા પ્રેમનું ઊંડાણ અમે પ્રભુ આપ માપી શકીએ એમ નથી મારા પ્રભુ અમે એના માટે આભાર જ માનીએ છીએ મારા દેવ એના માટે તમારી સ્તુતિ જ કરીએ છીએ અને આરાધના જ કરીએ છીએ મારા પ્રભુ એ શરીર જે કાલવાળી ટેકરી પર વધસ્તંભ અમારા માટે ભાંગવામાં આવ્યું છે તેને માટે તમારો આભારને ઉપકાર માનીએ છીએ મારા દેવ એ રક્ત જે કાલવાળી ટેકરી પર પ્રભુ સ્વભાવ એ પ્રભુ આપ ક્રોસ પર અમારે સારું વેવડાવવામાં આવ્યું છે તેને માટે તમારો આભાર જ માનીએ છીએ પ્રભુ સ્વભાવ આ પ્રભુ સુબાપ હલવાન કે જે જગતના મંડાણની અગાઉ પ્રભુ સુબાપ જેને પ્રભુ બાપ જેનો વધ કરવામાં આવ્યો હતો પ્રભુ સુબાપ એ હલવાનને માટે અમે તમારો આભારને ઉપકાર માનીએ છીએ એ અમારા પાપોને સારું વેવડાવવામાં આવેલા એ રક્તને માટે તમારો આભારને ઉપકાર માનીએ છીએ આ પ્રભુ સુબાપ અમને સાજાપણું આપવા માટે એ ભાંગવામાં આવેલા શરીરને માટે તમારો આભારને ઉપકાર માનીએ છીએ મારા પ્રભુ મારા દેવ મારા ઈશ્વર પ્રભુ સુબાપ તમારા પવિત્ર ચરણોમાં સોંપાઈએ છીએ મારા પ્રભુ તમે ગ્રેશિયસ દેવ છો મારા દેવ તમે પ્રભુ બાપ કૃપા કરવામાં ઉતાવળા દેવ છો તમે ક્રોધ કરવામાં ધીમા અને દયા કરવામાં ઉતાવળા એવા ગ્રેશિયસ પ્રભુ છો તમારો આભારને ઉપકાર માનીએ છીએ તમે રાજાઓના રાજા અને પ્રભુઓના પ્રભુ છો તેમ છતાં મારા હૃદયમાં આવીને વસો એટલા નમ્ર છો તમારો આભારને ઉપકાર માનીએ છીએ તમારા પવિત્ર ચરણો અમારી જાતોને સોંપીએ છીએ મારા દેવ હા મારા દેવ મારા પ્રભુને મારા ઈશ્વર જેમ દાઉદ ગીત શાસ્ત્રી પ્રાર્થના કરે છે તેમ મારા દેવ અમારામાં શુદ્ધદય ઉત્પન્ન કરો અમારા આત્માને તમે નવો અને દ્રઢ કરો મારા પ્રભુ મારા દેવને મારા પ્રભુને મારા ઈશ્વર તમે અમારી પાસે શું માગો છો મારા દેવ હા મારા દેવ અમે મારા પાપો કબૂલ કરી શકીએ એ માટે અમને કૃપા આપો મારા દેવ તમે અમને કૃપા આપો મારા દેવ જેમ દાઉદ સર્ચ મી ઓ માય લોર્ડ એન્ડ ટેસ્ટ મી ઓ માય લોર્ડ મારા માં કોઈ પણ જાતનો દુરાચાર હોય તો પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ તમે અમને શુદ્ધ કરો મારા દેવ, અમારા પાપો કબૂલ કરવા માટે મારા દેવ તમે અમને કૃપા આપો મારા દેવ. હા પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ, અમે હાર્ડન હાર્ટ ના થઈએ મારા દેવ, અમારા હૃદયોમાં કઠણતા ના હોય મારા દેવ, અમારા મનોની અંદર પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ કોઈ પણ જાતનો અંધકાર ના રહે મારા પ્રભુ, પરંતુ તમારા પ્રકાશથી મારા દેવ સઘળી બાબતો પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ તમારા પ્રકાશમાં આવે તે માટે તમારી આગળ કૃપા માંગીએ છીએ મારા પ્રભુ, કે તમે અમને સામર્થ્યથી તમારા પરાક્રમથી ભરપૂર કરો મારા દેવ, તમારા પવિત્ર આત્માથી ભરપૂર કરો મારા દેવ, અને પવિત્ર આત્મા દેવ તમે અમને કન્વિક્શન આપો મારા દેવ કે અમે અમારા પાપો કબૂલ કરી શકીએ મારા દેવ, કે જેથી કરીને પ્રભુ ઈસુ ખ્રિસ્તના રક્તમાં અમે પોતાની જાતોને શુદ્ધ અને પવિત્ર કરી શકીએ, અને અમે સર્વ અન્યાયથી શુદ્ધ થઈએ, અને પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ તમારી પવિત્ર પ્રજા જે બનવા માટે તમે અમને તેડ્યા છે તેવા અમે બની શકીએ મારા પ્રભુ. તમારા પવિત્ર ચરણોમાં સોંપાય ત્યારે જે કમ્યુનિયન લેવા અમે જઈ રહ્યા છીએ પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ, તમારા શરીરના અને તમારા રક્તના ભાગીદાર થવા જઈ રહ્યા છે, ત્યારે પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ અમારા જીવનો અને પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ તમારા ચરણોમાં સોંપીએ છીએ મારા પ્રભુ. એ લેવાથી પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ, એ ખાધા અને પીધાથી પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ અમે તમારામાં પ્રભુ આ વધુ વૃદ્ધિ પામીએ મારા દેવ, વધુ ફળવંત બનીએ, એ કૃપા સ્વરૂપ થવા દો. ફરીને એકવાર બેઠેલી એક એક વ્યક્તિને પ્રભુ તમારા ચરણોમાં સોંપું છું, દરેકના આત્મા પ્રાણ અને શરીરને તમારા ચરણોમાં લાવીએ છીએ મારા દેવ. અમારા સઘળા પર તમારી કૃપા સદા સર્વકાળ પ્રભુ બાપ એવી ને એવી રે પ્રાર્થના વિનંતી કરીએ છીએ, અને અમે તમારી કૃપાનો કોઈ પણ દિવસે અવર્થા અંગીકાર ન કરીએ મારા દેવ, પરંતુ હંમેશા પ્રભુ ઈસુ બાપ તમારા પ્રકાશમાં ચાલીએ માટે અમારા પર કૃપા થવા દો. ઇન ધ નેમ ઓફ જીસસ વી પ્રે,
આમેન. આમેન. થેન્ક યુ જીસસ. Brothers will have the elements of communion. I would request you to come forward, take the communion, go back to your seat, keep it in prayer. We're going to pray together and take communion together. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, please.
Thank you, Lord.
Teri shri avaaz main sunta hu khuda pura deep azuz chashme ke
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Join with me in prayer as we ask for the repentance of our sins, as we receive the covenant blood, life blood, cleansing blood, protecting blood, receive health and healing into our lives as well. All the deadness be gone. Thank you, Jesus. Feel free to kneel down, bow down, stand up, whatever you feel like doing. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we want to say thank you, and we want to praise you, and we want to worship you, Father God. Thank you that you have called us to your table right now, my Lord. And Lord, it is your call unto our life, oh my Lord, that you call us to, Lord, partake in your flesh and partake in your blood, Father God. We want to say thank you for that, oh my Lord. We want to say thank you because you want us to grant the life that is through your blood, Father God. We want to say thank you for that, oh my Lord. And as we come into your presence, Lord, you have even given us that privilege which was privy to only a few people in Old Testament, Father God. But you extend it to each one of us, Father God, through Christ Jesus. We want to say thank you for that right now, my Lord. And Lord, as we understand the meaning of it, oh my Lord, Lord, we want to have the same sincerity, same reverence, Father God, every time we come to your table, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord. Right now, as we come into your presence, Father God, we ask for that we repent, Father God, and ask for the forgiveness of the sins that we know we have committed, Father God, oh my Lord. Anger, frustration, Father God, speech, thought, Father God, works, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord. We bring it everything to you, Father God. Nothing is hidden from you, Father God. We have the thoughts of lust, Father God, we bring it to you. We have fits of anger, we bring it to you, Father God. We have hidden things going into our life that is shameful, we bring it to you, Father God. Lord, we want to expose everything that is shameful to the word of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God. And Lord, according to your word, Father God, we receive cleansing from you, Father God. We just don't say sorry, Father God, but we repent, Father God. We want to turn around. We want to have a different lifestyle, Father God. We want to grow in the image and likeness of Lord Jesus Christ. We want to walk in the holiness and righteousness of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God. Lord, let your blood cleanse us, Father God, from all unrighteousness, Father God. Any stubbornness, Father God. Any disobedience, Father God. Any loose tongues, Father God. Hallelujah. Anything that is there which is not God glorifying, that is not according to your word, we bring it to you, Father God. Cleanse us in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord. We do not want to partake in an unworthy manner because your word says many are weak and sick and some have premature death, Father God. We do not want to be weak, Father God. We want to be strong in Christ Jesus, oh my Lord. We don't want to be sick, Father God, but we want to receive this healing through the blood of Lord Jesus Christ, oh my Lord. And we do not want to die prematurely because we have purpose, oh my Lord, here in the face of this earth to proclaim your name, to glorify your name and live a life that will exalt your name, oh my Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We want to fulfill the purpose that you sent us for in this earth, Father God. Hallelujah. As we come into your presence, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord. All the weaknesses be gone, Father God, is my prayer. All the sicknesses be gone, Father, is my prayer. All the curses of premature deaths be gone by the blood of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God. We do not walk into that disobedience, Father God, Father God. But we want to walk in that obedience. We want to obey that spiritual principle that you mentioned in this word, which has been read before us year after year after year. But a lot of time we have ignored it, Father God. We have confessed and we have walked away and we are the same, Father God, in certain areas into our life, Father God. We want to have that victory, Father God, today in those areas, Father God, because your blood makes us victorious. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, oh my Lord. I pray in Jesus' name, hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Make us victorious in Christ Jesus, Father God. And Lord, hallelujah, we come to this table by faith right now. We do not doubt, oh my Lord, because your word says nobody receives by doubting, oh my Lord. But we come by faith and by confession, oh my Lord, that we receive the promises that is in the word of God through Christ Jesus into our life, Father God. We receive the healing that was proclaimed in Isaiah chapter 53, Father God. We receive the covenant blessing, Father God. God, we receive this. We receive, my Lord, that there is no plan of enemy will prosper against us, oh my Lord, because we are marked by the blood of Lord Jesus Christ, oh my Lord. We have covenant sign upon us, Father God. Lord, I pray in Jesus' name, Lord, if anybody has suffered the loss because of sin and disobedience, I pray in Jesus' name, let there be forgiveness and repentance, Father God. And whatever enemy has stolen, Father God, your word says, hallelujah, Lord, whatever locust has stolen, you can restore it, Father God. So I speak restoration on the lives of people who repent right now, Father God. Restoration, Father God, like never before, Father God, is my prayer. Every good and perfect blessing that flows from your life, flows from your blood, flows from your body, be given into each one of us, Father God. Hallelujah. If anybody's eyes are still closed, Father God, let the revealing blood be applied, Father God. No complacency, Father God. Not live the life same the way we were living for years and years and years, Father God. But tangible changes, hallelujah, Lord, is my prayer right now, Father God. Hallelujah. When we receive this body, Father God, we receive the body of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God, which is sinless, Father God, which is able to save us. When we receive the blood of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God, hallelujah, we receive the revelation, Father God. We receive the cleansing. We receive restoration. We receive healing in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever doctor's report may say, oh my Lord, whatever a sickness's name is, oh my Lord, but the name of the Lord Jesus Christ is higher than every other name, oh my Lord. And we make our sicknesses surrender to that name of Lord Jesus Christ, oh my Lord. We receive healing over every ulcer, every wound, every breast cancer, every psoriasis, every backache, neckache, pain, oh my Lord, every, hallelujah, sickle cell anemia, oh my Lord, we receive healing over everything in Jesus' name, Father God. Hallelujah, my Lord. We receive healing over stroke and heart attacks in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God. We receive healing over, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, any barrenness in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name, Father God. As we come into your presence, we come with also confidence, at the same time with fear and trembling, Father God. Let the fear of the Lord be established into our heart and mind. Let the reverence of your presence, let the reverence of your word, the reverence of your worship be established into our heart and mind, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord. Help us to be the people who will revere your presence, who will long for your presence. And when your presence are manifested, Father God, we will be very careful not to quench the Holy Spirit, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, once again, we want to say thank you for the sinless blood that was shed for us and sinless body that was broken for us, oh my Lord. We receive it, Father God. We receive the communion, Father God, and we abide in you and you abide in us, Father God. So the life that we live in this flesh, my Lord, we will live in the strength and the glory of Most High God, Father God. We submit ourselves. We surrender ourselves. Hallelujah. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Jesus. Let us join with me in disciples' prayer together. Thank our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Deliver us from the evil.
Forgive us those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Forever and ever. Amen. Mother, thank you, Jesus. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Dev Bapno Jaib Jo Prem. Prabhu Shri Krishna Krupa. And Pavitra Atmani Mitu Madhuri Sangat. Ap Sarvani Sade. Hamnathi Sada Sarokar Sudhi Hojo. Amen. Amen.